of whoever faces him in the finals. We still got to figure that one out because we have Licorice and Professor Akali just about ready to do battle here.
And I'm really curious if Licorice will ban Akali and doesn't. This is interesting. No player at all so far in the Red Bull 1v1 tournament has banned Akali against the man who's like, by the way, broadcasting, this is my champion.
Yeah, because it's in the name.
Yeah. I know in one of the matches I had cast before, I think it was with Hanjaro, like, he's a big support player and was like 1.5 million mastery on Pyke. And the very first ban from Jensen was, I'm banning Pyke, screw you. And it was just like, oh, okay, you want to win, I see. And then he got knocked out anyway. So, hey, good job, Jensen, way to deny the fun. In Licorice's case, he's like, you know, whether it's hubris, whether it's, you know, put on a good show for the homies, you know, whatever it is. But, you know, this is what FlyQuest is all about is, you know, being friendly, helping the environment, you know, helping people out. And it's like, look, yeah, you can play your main champion. It's cool. He's, you know, starting the good nature.
Is that how you help
league.
The environment? You don't ban Akali from the
yes.
Akali players?
Yeah. You know, look, FlyQuest, my branding services are for sale here. TreeQuest was great. SeaQuest was really good as well. I think your 2021 branding should be We Don't Ban Akali.
That's going to
go really far. Yeah.
Freak, I think if you ever decide that you're done doing champion spotlights and casting and just general League of Legends stuff, you got a promising career in brand opportunities, my friend.
I think so. Absolutely.
It's always also, important to have the backup plan.
Yeah. It's also a good support pick, right? So, you know, you've got a lot of good brand opportunities in this one. He's like actually pretty good. You know, you can buy double injuries.
Fantastic.
Yeah, there we go. We put it all together.
All right, so Lulu locked in for the 1v1 here. We've been talking a lot about the Akali, most of it just completely worthless meme stuff. But talking about Lulu for a second, I was seeing some people talk about Lulu feeling really strong recently in their preseason games that they were playing. So I'm not super surprised to see it picked here in the 1v1 because it can be a pain in the butt to deal with.
So for those who weren't watching the patch notes from about 2 weeks ago, there's a big update to Lulu, basically just a Glitter Lance, where it actually can double hit now. Instead of just refreshing the slow duration and the slow potency, it'll actually double hit. The second shot does 25% damage. There is no longer a fall off for going through minions. So if you hit a champion once or twice, it's more damage than pre-patch in almost all cases. But there's a minion drop off. Minions just take only 3/4 damage. So the wave clear is neutral to slightly worse. But the PvP damage is higher in almost all cases. So Licorice right now doing pretty good damage to Akali right here. Obviously, I think the Lulu E does reveal full stealth. I know there's some reveal abilities like Kog'Maw ult that doesn't reveal stealth, but I believe Lulu E does. So he just has easy counterplay against all the stealth mechanics and, you know, just presses EQ and gets free poke.
I'm not going to lie to you, Mr. Freak. I did not pay attention to that part of the patch notes because it wasn't about Skarner. So I didn't know he had the double hit on the Glitter Lance. That's actually terrifying. If you can manage to line both of those up and find that damage, you can see Licorice with a huge advantage so far here, man. Now, don't get me wrong. There's a lot of minions still left to pick up. What is that? 9, 8, something like that, still standing here for Professor Akali to farm. So he'll be able to alleviate some of this discrepancy. But still, it's a 16 CS lead right now for Licorice here on the Lulu.
Yeah, and you can see there's just no way in. I mean, Lulu is defensible enough. I really like the double Doran's Ring start. It's mana sustained. It's a bunch of health as well. It's just, I mean, they're very efficient items. If you can get away with it, you should do it. And Kali's just getting components, right? Gets the MR version of Arm Guard. That's the one item I don't know the name of, actually, I think, in the entirety of the season, because the item was just so bad that I never bothered to learn it.
MR version of Arm Guard? Wait, do you mean Hex Drinker?
No, it's APMR.
Oh, yeah, I didn't even know that existed. I'm not going to lie to you. Like, whenever I think the other version of Arm Guard, I think of Hex Drinker, right?
Right,
because
sure.
Those were always the two that, like, you look at and think, okay, if you're really worried about getting killed in lane by some bursty thing, you can build this if you're the right champion for the type. Yep. Didn't even know we had it.
Verdant, yeah, it's called Verdant Barrier. It's the green necklace. So it's you know, APMR, you get MR, like, every minute, which is, like, hastened if you take damage from magic. So it's already fully stacked. It's now, you know, the fully stacked Arm Guard. It's, again, practically the same item. And here we go. The first all-in comes in. Akali wants damage up on Licorice, gets the self-ult, puts the healing in, and just kind of walks it away. You just don't have the damage. You just can't you can't push through that much damage on the Lulu.
Look at Lulu's health bar.
It's full. He went Hex Drinker. Like, look at the fact that he went AD Lulu.
Yeah, it's AD Lulu, and he's not stopping at just Hex Drinker either. He's got that Caulfield's Warhammer ready to go bonk, bonk, bonk right on Professor Akali every time he walks up. That'll get turned into a Maul of Malmortius, and that's going to provide a very powerful shield for the next time Professor Akali tries to go all in here. This is a scary situation for our Akali player.
And it's one of the updates that I think was correct to do for Akali. They converted her Shuriken flip into pure magic damage, which I think is good. It lets her buy magic pen. It feels better for a champion. It's overall stronger. But it also means that stacking pure MR works even better than it would have before, because now they don't have a physical damage spell. Even the Hexic Alternator that got picked up a second ago, and you know, it's basically just Revolver from pre-patch, but it works on spells now. That's also magic damage. So, you know, Licorice is just tanking all of it, can just self-shield whenever, and that's obviously very, very efficient when you've got, you know, 112 MR in a full build here.
Licorice on this Lulu, man. Just nobody in League of Legends wants to lane against this. I feel like there'd probably be people that pick the really dishonorable stuff like Vayne top or Quinn top, and they wouldn't even want to play into this. Like, yeah, this Lulu is fearsome right now. I don't know how Professor Akali is going to find an opportunity here, because he's so far down in terms of economy too. Like, yeah, you've got that green thing, and you've got a ruby crystal, but your opponent, as soon as he backs, can buy Maw of Malmortius and probably a full boot too.
So the one saving grace is, you mentioned cannons being worth more. Cannons have missing gold on them. If you're down 1K, the cannon's worth like 150 more. So if he gets it, Akali, don't screw this up.
Oh,
okay, yeah.
262.
So 262. Yeah. And if you watch Licorice get a cannon, he'll get less than that. But now another all-in goes in. First shield comes off. First ult comes in as well. Akali in the chase down. Dodges the Glitter Lances. And that's going to force Barrier out as well. You can see big damage comes in. And it's just not enough. He's out of energy. And Licorice is back at, you know, 60%.
Yeah, Licorice, that was probably like worst case scenario for him. Missing the Glitter Lance, having to fall back, not being in a spot where he feels like he can fight. And even though he loses the fight, what does he actually lose here is the real question.
Yep.
And the answer is not much. As he goes back to base, picks up some more items. Look at that. Doran's Ring, Ruby Crystal Boot, and that Maw that we were talking about. So very scary right now. We'll see what Professor Akali is able to go back and purchase, as once Licorice arrives back to lane, there are so many minions waiting on him.
Look at the belt. Double Giant's belt. The item got more efficient in the preseason. They buffed that actually a lot. It's a really good item now. So it's just like, all right, screw it. I'll try to tank you out. I dig that. Do you want to point out that Akali got his next cannon as well? 242 for the second cannon. You can see it was less because the missing gold wasn't so bad, but it's still the recalls come through. Maw completed. Boots are in. Both level 11. We'll see if 12 can come in, possibly. It's unlikely here, but theoretically is available, and they're going to be doing battle, and we'll see who can tank whom.
All right, boys, it's almost time. The fire is just about closed in. Level 11, barrier and ignite not up for barrier not up for Licorice, ignite not up for Professor Akali, but we do have the Akali flash. Akali also critically not having the ulti ready to go here just yet.
And he has to fight the mini wave as well.
How long he wants to wait.
He's going to try to clear,
but he's taken, though.
Oh my gosh, he's already at half.
Licorice already has him to half.
Yeah. I mean, Blue Elixir is just very, very good. Smart Elixir should buy it. Akali, there's no way he has the damage here, right?
Yep.
There's just no way. Goodbye.
What are you going to do? See you later, man. I feel like going into this next one, you got to ban Lulu. If you're Professor Akali, you've got to take that off the table.
And I am actually curious, because it's not like I play much top lane, certainly not much Akali either. I'm sure he has a list of top laners that are good into Akali. Like, he must know them. He must know that champion pool. Maybe that was actually, he banned the top three, and Licorice was like, well, number four is Lulu, so yeah, we're good. I'm curious what's going to look like here in game two. I agree that Lulu probably shows up on the ban table, but I'm also curious if he tries to bait into something else and picks a different champion. So yeah, Riven comes through, Renekton on the other side. That'll be fun to watch.
Yeah, this is one of your classic solo queue top lane matchups, right? The Riven versus the Renekton. So let's see how they get this one going here, as neither player willing to back away at the level one.
Ooh.
Level three, I guess I should say. They're both going to be going all the way in. Ignites are used. Licorice going for a little bit more damage here on Professor Akali. And just like that, first blood at level three.
Top
one
diff.
Of these men is an LCS player.
One of these players plays in bronze half his games, and look what's happening to him now. Maybe you should play against Master Tier players more often.
Licorice just showed him that you had best not be trying to skill check him in the top lane champion 1v1, because he is not the kind of dude that is going to abide that. No, sir. Licorice getting that first blood for himself, goes back to base, and look at that. Freak Phage plus two Dorans. He is feeling great right about now.
Yeah, this is a recurring trend for Licorice. He started last game double Doran, started this game double Doran's. I mean, the gigantic health lead. I mean, Doran's items are absurdly efficient, and you can always finish a mythic or a big legendary by the time you're into sort of the endgame scenario. So I think Licorice is building correctly for these kind of things. Akali, yep, he's out of cooldowns, but you can see Licorice is like, but I'm tanky. I get health regen off Phage. I have all the health off Phage and double Doran's. Like, you're not... Yeah, Vamp's not going to do anything, bud.
Yeah, like, what are you supposed to do against that? As look, Licorice is just going, and Professor Akali's at 200 HP. This is not the big scary alligator that you see on Animal Planet that the zebras are too afraid to walk up to the watering hole for. This is like the pet iguana that's sitting inside a terrarium asleep on a rock. He just can't fight back.
He's the ones that went extinct when the meteor hit Earth, you know, just like, yeah, he's all gone. No,
the meteor was riven.
Yeah, the meteor was riven, I think is a fair one to say here.
Well, the meteor was that Q3 out of the brush at level 3 to just annihilate him.
Yeah.
Okay, he's got some fury now, but his opponent has level 6.
He's actually dead. Oh, okay. He had dashes up, so he saved the ult.
Professor Akali, I will give it to Professor Akali. Good use of the slice there to actually time it to dash through his opponent and be able to make sure he gets all the distance to get away. Because if he actually gets stuck at a spot, level 4 versus level 6 Riven, dude, you're dead twice over. No way out of that.
So I just thought of a pun that's text only. It would be spelling the word distance with a C instead of an S, because then it would be like distance, because he went far with slice and dice. So you'd... Yeah. The complete silence. I know you always say, every time he makes dumb jokes in the caster lounge, you're like, you can't give him the groan, that gives him power. You just have to not talk. But the 5 seconds of silence is just as good as the groan flowers. That's my secret. There's no way to make me not enjoy this.
You just... You get way too much energy out of this, dude. Okay, so Freak's currently coming up with no audio is allowed versions of puns. They only work if you read them. Unfortunately for you all at home, you're listening to us, so it doesn't really make any sense anyway.
Just hit the Windows key, type in Notepad, and then write DICETANCE, and it's like, that's a good joke, Freak. Good job.
Then you get the joke. Yes, just open up Notepad. Or type it in Twitch chat, then you'll be able to make it work.
Yeah. Everyone in Twitch chat, just type distance.
Let's see what's going on with the game here real quick. I kind of lost track of what was going on in the middle of that.
Licorice is winning. Professional
intellectual
opinion.
Debate. So Licorice with the plated steel caps. He's got the extra movement speed to make sure he's able to stay caught up to his opponent. Extra armor to survive some of the Renekton burst. Professor Akali going for the serrated Dirk here. So his opponent immediately stacking armor. I love that response to lethality. It's just saying, all right, bro, I don't care about your lethality. See you later. My itemization's better.
Yeah, based on items, this is Eclipse. If he's going for a mythic at all, it is. Which is, I mean, pretty good on 1v1. It's a big shield. It's a big chunk of damage. It makes sense as far as a duel like this is concerned. I don't imagine, like, Triforce something would be better. I know oftentimes if you're playing, like, a 5v5, you actually really want to go Gore Drinker on Renekton, but you're not against five champions, so it's really hard to make Gore Drinker look good when you can't hit off of five people. So he's getting the small version, and, loses half his health instantly. But if he has Eclipse, right, that looks a lot better. He gets a big shield, he heals a bunch. Like, that's actually a comparable fight.
Yeah, Licorice just instantly... And that wasn't a lot of the Riven combo, either. That was E-auto, Q1 auto.
Yeah.
That's... pretty scary when he can do that with not even the good parts of his combo. So
he hasn't ulted
Licorice
at all
just,
this game yet.
Yeah, he's just waiting. He's just waiting for Professor Akali to have to come near him. They both have all the summoners ready to go. They both have ultis ready to fire as well. Licorice may just be waiting for Ring of Fire, making sure he doesn't accidentally expend anything beforehand, so he's completely ready when that shows up, and then just goes in for the all-in.
I think that makes sense, honestly.
Oh, wow. Nice bait there. Professor Akali getting a little bit scared, a little jumpy on the summoner spells.
All right, recall's coming through. Now, again, the game will warn you when there's a 30-second timer until the sudden death starts, so you're not in a huge rush. Interesting, Licorice is going for Gore Drinker himself. Again, I don't think it's absurdly good. It's something like you get 110% of your total attack damage and 12% of missing health on the active. It's another sort of spell to cancel your other stuff in. Like, it's pretty solid. I wouldn't even hate to see Stridebreaker, which would be similar damage. But regardless, I think this is solid. Of course, we have the Eclipse in already. And clearly a big item lead in here as well for Licorice with the fact that he's got, steel caps versus just the cloth armor.
Steel Caps plus the extra two Dorian's Blades on top of it. So much extra power here for him. And with that level 11 coming around, you know what that means, my dear friends at home in the Twitch chat. It's just about time for the Ring of Fire. The message on the screen now says it's 25 seconds to go. Professor Akali is down two levels. He should be able to at least shore up one of those before the fire arrives. Okay, there we go. He's level 10. He wants to try to clear out as much of this minion wave as possible to get level 11, make it fair.
So, knocked down the rest of the wave. Licorice is probably not going to get his recall stopped. Goes far back just in case, but Akali like has to take the whole wave down. Like, there's no way you can drop the CS. 287 from the cannon because he needs the money that badly. Tries to get as many of the ways as he can. But now this means that Akali like almost can't recall in time. Like, it's at this point, it's too late. So all that money meant absolutely nothing. I would like to see a slightly earlier recall to pick in something, but now Red Elixir is in, extra longsword.
Yeah, the money is just worthless. The whole point was just making sure he's level 11 before Licorice can do anything, which he would have got anyway because all the minions went underneath the turret. Licorice now level 12.
Yep.
The fire is closing in. Both mythic items ready to go. Licorice, as you just mentioned, has the red pot.
Yep.
Honestly,
right about now,
you
pop the elixir.
5 minutes, you can drink it.
You pop the elixir and you pop the ult. Because this point, like, the fight's going to last 10 seconds anyway. And by that point, it's, you know, going to still be
there
active.
There we go. Professor Akali using the ulti first, going in after Licorice. We'll be able to take a good amount of health off of him. And right now, it's Professor Akali in a bad spot, and Licorice will take him out again. Call that one another 2-0, even taking down Professor Akali on his namesake champion. And Licorice will move on to face High in the finals on Sunday.
Yeah, it's going to be exciting. I mean, really well done to Licorice. Had the huge outplay counterpick there in the Lulu versus Akali in game one. And then, I mean, absolutely smashed Riven versus Renekton in game two. The face check level one obviously was pretty important. Had a level lead and an item lead the entire time since then. It's hard to like get back in a melee 1v1 matchup. But still, again, very, very well played by him. Licorice took down Darkwings, who was the Rebel 1v1 like online tournament champion, which is exciting. Took down Voi in the very first round as well. So, you know, the stairs weren't enough. Licorice just walked all over him.
Oh, this is going to be a fun final between these two guys, especially just the way that they both played their semifinals out. Clearly, both of them were a cut above their opponents, and that just means we get to see these two dudes go head-to-head. I hope we get to see all three games